Wow, this is interesting. I have a couple of clips that I made today that I don't know if I'm going to post or not. Just frivolous things. Now, I get, I guess it's a blog of some sort. I don't know, it's some sort of email thing, and it's called Before It's News. So if you type that, you can find it, and this is the source. And this is dated January 19th, 2012. We're already in February, but whatever. This article is called The Alterverse of Willful Ignorance. Now, I have been wondering over the past couple of years a lot about people who think they're smart, and they never are, and also people who just kind of shut things out. You know, they don't want to hear it or know it, and when you try to talk to them about stuff, they just close you off. And I think that a lot of them do it with very bad manners. I mean, you know, if you really don't want to hear somebody, you know, you can just say, would you like some more tea? Or, I'm sorry, I have to go. Or, I don't know, you know. But I've also been noticing over the past couple of years, I started to have a lot of problems a couple of years ago, getting attacked by friends, family, employer, stuff like that. 2009 was the best year of my life. I was just fine then, and it all came crashing down at the beginning of 2010. Whenever I meet somebody who says they don't like brain-dead people, I often find that they are brain dead. So I think we all have to dig ourselves a lot. You know, I mean, if we think we're awake or we know what's going on, it is probably time for a reality check. Now, this is written by somebody called Zen Gardner, and it has to do with levels of awareness and stuff. And I guess you could call it the Matrix or something. I'm not really sure. I don't really like referencing that movie, although it was a very cool movie. I really liked it. It says stuff like, a lot of people seem very sleepy. They don't want to rock the boat. And yet this kind of attitude renders them vulnerable. Now, I would say, on the other hand, if you're hypervigilant, if you're paranoid, this also makes you vulnerable to all kinds of manipulation. Now, this discusses the weaponization of ignorance, which is an interesting thought, and Charlotte Easerbeat has talked about the dumbing down of America, gone through the public education system. Very interesting. You know, since I've been out of the USA for so many years, I have a different perspective, than I used to, which is normal. I'm an expatriate. And when I remind people back in the States of, you know, people my age, of what we learned in public school, they're like, oh yeah, I forgot about that. You know, what made them forget, and what makes me still remember? I must say, I was disoriented when I first got out of the United States. I had a lot of anti-socialist, anti-communist, knee-jerk, prejudiced reactions to stuff that I didn't really understand why it had been ingrained into me. So it's been an eye-opener, being away from a TV set for nearly 20 years and stuff has been great. I recommend it. Now, this sort of talks about what they want us to become. Now, this could be in any country. You know, we are basically just products. We are supposed to work and produce and pay taxes. And, you know, I had a little dispute with a person recently online whose son volunteered for the military and served for quite a few years in the military. And I am just so against that. And my current husband had to go into the military. It was obligatory here in France for a long time. But he did his time and just made sure that he was useless to them. And I was kind of surprised by his attitude, but I came to see his way of thinking. You know, he was just like, I don't approve of war, and I don't approve of the military industrial complex, and I had to be there for about a year and a half, and I just made sure that I acted as stupid as possible and was completely uncooperative. So he did his time and he got out, you know. I was kind of like, okay, fine. You know, if you... What really bothers me is, like, people who have children or family members in the military or who have been in the military, they immediately get this, like, reaction, like, oh, they made the right choice, you know. Did they? You know, they weren't smart enough to do anything else. They just wanted to be a cog in the machine of the military industrial complex. I mean, what does that say about them? I don't know. You know, my own mother wanted me to join the Navy because she hadn't saved for me to go to college, and she wanted me to get the GI Bill and stuff. This was back in the 70s. And that was just an unthinkable thing to me. You know, I already knew what was going on in the Navy, and the women I knew who were in it were rampant, aggressive lesbians who scared me. And I just can't believe anybody would throw themselves into that. So this says, what if everyone woke up? What is reality? You just type before it's news, and you can see this article, The Alterverse of Willful Ignorance by Zen Gardner. That's an interesting pseudonym. And this talks about One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I just keep having to deal with people who seem really, really, really asleep and not willing to listen to my own point of view at all, which I try to keep reasonable. And if it's not, you know, it's time for the cup of tea again and just say, excuse me, I have to back off. I'm sorry I ruffled your feathers. But I seem to be in contact with a lot of people who are seriously mentally ill. They are just not functioning. And a lot of them are on benefits, which really bothers me. Have never worked, haven't been able to do anything, totally lack discipline. And I find myself, oh, this is hard to admit, but I find myself almost in favor of eugenics, really. A lot of people should never have been born. And I was definitely one of them, definitely. Thank heavens my parents aborted their third child, and my father got a vasectomy. And I've discussed this with my brother. You know, we were quite adrift. Now this talks about smoke and mirrors and a controllable presupposed existence. Barbaric wars, an obviously controlled banking and economic system, and blinding, debasing religious dogmas and rigmarole. And it says, well, that's still a reality. So is the torturous world of someone who is mentally, so is the torturous world of someone who is mentally disturbed. Would you call that reality? If not, what in you is telling you that it is something more than that poor, tortured soul's version? And to what degree are all of us tortured or deprived souls compared to some great, vastly greater and more wonderful reality? Get the picture, it's consciousness watching through you. Well, all I can say is that I am far from perfect. You know, just because I got cleared a year or two ago from and declared sane, doesn't mean that I am, you know. And it doesn't mean that my point of view is the best one or the right one, or, you know, that I can inflict anything on you. Because I can't, that would be wrong. I could discuss it with you. We could talk about it. But I'm really against, like, force and barbarism, if you want to call it that. And I hope this makes sense to you. I'm not sure I'm going to post this video or not. It says here, none of this has to be. There are no poor, ignorant masses. Ignorant, perhaps, but not so poor they can't wake up. We all have the spiritual resources at any given time to have absolutely thrilling and fulfilling lives. And I think that that is true to a great extent because, you know, even if you're a very narrow-minded person, you know, wearing those blinders on you, you might still enjoy going to church or being in an organized religion or reading a sacred text. And it might get you to thinking a little bit outside of the box. So I would say even for the most conventional, there's enormous hope. But I'm just astonished by the hostility that I'm getting from some people. Friends, family, spouse, employer. You know, I seem to be the problem, and yet I'm doing pretty much everything I can to be polite and go along with the program. But it all really makes me wonder, what the F is the program? You know, what should I do? You know, start punching them in the face and demanding they wake up and becoming a criminal myself? You know, I don't really think that that's the answer. But you do have to wonder about people who are willfully ignorant. And perhaps a lot of you have had experiences with trying to help people out, trying to wake them up, trying to heal them, trying to look after them. I had a tremendously bad experience with Bruce David Thorpe here for 2 months in 2010. I've got a lot of videos up about him. You know, this guy was just like a sponge, and he was stealing stuff from me and breaking stuff and lying, and was using the word hipster and, you know, pretending he was smart when he seemed to have a single digit IQ. And I just wonder about all this, and believe me, I wonder about myself also, and I try to remain humble. I don't have all the answers. I am far from perfect. So you all have a good day. I'm going to stop now. Okay, bye.